Morning Children, Standard 8, Subject History, Lesson Number 9, Changing Life 1. Yes, children, in our previous lecture, we have seen the introduction of the chapter Changing Life 1. Then we have studied about the institutions of the family. We have studied about the social welfare, scheduled caste and the tribes, public health, kidney transplantation, test tube baby. These are the points we have studied in our previous lecture. Now, today we are going to proceed further of the lesson, and that our point is immunization. Yes, children, now I am going to read it. Every one of you all just pay attention and then I will explain it to you all. Okay. So, here goes my reading. Page number 49, immunization. Before 1978, every year 6 India infants out of every 10 who were born faced the fatal health problems in very first year of their birth. The immunization program was taken up to overcome the threat of the polio, measles, tetanus, TB, diphtheria and whooping cough. The pulse polio immunization program started in 1995 has controlled the polio. Okay, children, I have read it. Now here I am going to explain it. Okay, so immunization is what? In the year of 1978, there was the rate of infant mortality and it was too very high. So what happened? This immunization program, it has brought under the control of what? Polio, like polio, measles, tetanus, TB, diphtheria and the whooping cough. These are the all immunization programs. So the pulse polio program, it was launched in the year that is in the year of 1995, and then after that it has successfully controlled the polio. Okay, children, moving on to the next point of reading, that is said as the urbanization. Okay, now I am going to read it. Urbanization. Urbanization is a process of the concentration of population in a city, or the urban areas. Increasing the population is one major reasons for the urbanization. A few other factors affecting the urbanizations are air, water and economic, as well as the social organization necessary for the community life. In the context of the post-independence India, the increase in the urban population is also due to the factors such as reductions in the mortality rate, industrialization, unavailabilities of the means of livelihood in the rural areas, job opportunities in the cities and the resulting migration. To reduce the strain on the cities, it is necessary to make the jobs available in the villages. Achieve a balance in the economic development. Control the expansions of the metros and provide the necessary services and facilities in both the urban as well as the rural areas. Okay, children, now I am going to explain you what is the urbanization topic. Yes, children, urbanization. Urbanization is what? It is one of the process of the migration. Okay, children, it is one of the process of migration where the population from the village and the cities, these villages and cities are the non-availabilities of what? Employment. So here in the rural areas after the independence, okay, children, in rural area after the independence, what happened here? The urban population is increased for what purpose? To the reductions of the mortality, to the reduction of what? Mortality rate. So industrialization, unavailabilities of the job in the rural areas, the good jobs are available in the cities also. Okay, so because of this, what happens? The balanced economic developments of the rural and the urban areas, this both area, there is a creation of job opportunities. So because of the job opportunities available to them, so their basic services will arrest the migrations. Okay, children, this is what about the urbanizations. Moving on to the next topic, that is what? Rural area. Now here, children, in rural area, what we are going to see, let us read. A village is a permanent settlement of the farmers near the land they themselves tilled there individually or collectively. Villages come into the existence when farming began. So, villages in India are thinly populated. a dense cluster of the houses surrounded by the farmland. By the farmland is a unique features of the Indian villages. A settlement smaller than even a village is called a hamlet. Then compared to the urban community, the village community is very small. Villages are not uniform across the India. There are differences based on the regional and the physical features. Okay, children. Now we are going to see about the rural area. How the life is changing in the rural area. So comparatively, now children, here in rural area, a village is a permanent settlement for the people like farmers. So these farmers, there is a land, and in this land they are individually or collectively. Villages in India are very thinly populated over there. Okay, so what happens as they are thinly populated, a dense cluster of the houses which is surrounded by the farmlands is a very unique features of the Indian village. So because of this feature, the settlement is smaller than a village is called as the hamlet. Okay children, where a settlement is very smaller than a village, we say it as a hamlet. So there is a regional and a physical differences in the villages. Okay children, now our next topic is what? Post independence period. Okay children, what is in the post independence periods? Let us study. Keeping in mind the goal of the rural development, the collective development scheme has come into the force. Plans were made for the improving farming technology, increasing the area of the irrigated land, extending the educational facilities, enacting the laws for the land reforms under this scheme. It also aimed at increasing the agricultural producers, as well as expanding the means of the transport, health services and scope for education in the rural areas. It was decided to give the priorities to the economic developments in the villages. The government undertook this work through the mediums of the Gram Panchayats, which include the people from all the castes and tribes to achieve this. The Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samitis and the Zilla Parishads were empowered with more authority. Okay children, now that is the next one point we are going to see, that is all about the post-independence period. Okay, so now before that we have studied about the rural area. So now what is after the rural area? That is the post-independence period. So here, to achieve the goal of the rural development, okay children, here what it is said here, that to achieve the goal of the rural development community, it has given a collective development program. What is that program? Collective development program, which is going to launch during the first 5-year plan. Okay, what it has said here, which is going to be launched at the first 5-year plan. So here it is saying that it was a development for the agriculture, like in agriculture what is all things are coming, like irrigation, village industries, education, land reforms, health and transport in the rural area. So just because of all this development, the responsibilities and the authorities of the rural development was entrusted to the Panchayati Raj institution. It was also in the year 1962 by the government. Okay children, so now our next topic, we will be studying it tomorrow. Till here I have explained it to you all. I hope every one of you must have understood it. Thank you.